What's going on, guys? PowerGPU here. Today we're going to be doing a benchmark of the RX 480 in Crossfire versus a single GTX 470, and we're going to be doing this on very high settings with anti-aliasing disabled, so that way I can get across the board. You could see the scaling from 1080p to 1440p to 2160p, because obviously at 4K with anti-aliasing you're not going to be able to run it, period, on Crysis 3. It's very hard. But as you can see there, the settings, I went ahead and showed them. So if you guys want to do these benchmarks at your house and compare them with your older video cards, you can if you like. You don't have to. It's up to you. On the left-hand side, you're going to be seeing the RX 480s in Crossfire. And first of all, as you can see, you're going to see the RX 480, the top one and the bottom one. Sometimes you'll see the usage go all the way down to 0%, which that just could be driver issues there. And I did notice some slight, very slight micro stutter with the Crossfire. And the other thing too is you're not going to see the temperature. Now the reason why you're not going to see the temperature is because MSI Afterburner does not fully support the RX 480s yet. So we're still waiting on an update for that to come out for it to fully support it, so that way you can actually see the temperatures while I'm doing these tests. One other thing to note as well, I went ahead and put the power limit plus 50, so that way it tries to stay at its constant 1266. But the cards got so hot, even with the fan profile, it got all the way up to 88 Celsius in my case, completely closed like you would have at home. So it was getting very hot. Now, one thing I will tell you though, even though if I had the fan profile pretty high, it still wasn't that loud, but these cards did get very hot in Crossfire. Like I said, 88 Celsius. In these videos that I did, it was only in about 10 to 12 minute increments, so I wasn't gaming for a very long time. But last night I did game on Overwatch while I was streaming on Twitch, and I went up to 87 Celsius, and it stayed right around 87, and I gamed for almost about 5 hours last night. So these cards do get hot, so keep that in mind if you do have a smaller case. The good thing is that the reference models do blow all the hot air out the case, so it's not in my case, just lingering, which is one good thing. One other thing that I want to tell you guys is the whole power issue thing that these cards have been supposedly having. I have had zero power issues. The machine has not shut off on me. I even used my Corsair the RM850. I used one single railing with 2 6 pins just to see that if it would actually shut off. I mean, it should be still be fine with the 2 6 pins, but nothing happened. And like I said, I've been benchmarking all day. I've been playing around with Crysis. I've been doing Fire Strike, which one thing surprisingly, if you guys are following me on Twitter, I did post some benchmark results on there as well. On Fire Strike, the two RX 480s beat a 1080 and a 1070, and it beats the 1080 by a few hundred points. I think it was almost like 600 points. I think I got more on the RX 480s. So these cards are pretty beast in Crossfire, and as you can see, it is pretty. It's destroying the 1070 single. And the reason why I wanted to do a video on the 1070 versus the RX 480 is because that way you guys can see price point comparison. So if you are comparing two RX 480s versus one 1070. And like I said in my previous video, I doubt someone's going to be comparing, I'm going to buy two RX 480s for about $470 or a 1080 for about $700. That's a big leap in price. I would say more that people are looking at comparing the RX 480 versus the GTX 1070, right? For this, right around the same price point, which was $455 for the 1070, about $478 for the two RX 480s. Now, one thing I do want you guys to keep in mind is, while you're watching these benchmarks, the RX 40 is beating the 1070 at 1080p, at 2K, and at 4K. Not by much, but it is beating it. But what you guys need to understand is, even though it's beating it, you're running a lot more wattage now. So you have a TDP of 150 on each card on top of that. So you're running double the watts, pretty much, because the 1070 is pretty close to that. And you're running a lot more heat in your machine. A lot more heat. I had a fan profile on both cards, on the RX 480 and the 1070, and as you can see on the 1070, temperatures are staying pretty stable in the 70 Celsius, low 70 Celsius. So the other cards got up to 88 Celsius. You're looking at easily a 15 plus Celsius difference, which is a big difference when it comes to gaming for hours on end. So, and you got to times that by two cards at 88 Celsius. So yeah. Me personally, I still prefer a single solution card. I always will. And I think that's why NVIDIA, if you notice with the new cards that are coming out, like the GTX 1060, I see no fins for it to actually do SLI support. I see nothing on there. So I think what they're trying to do is pretty much say only enthusiasts do SLI. which it makes sense because when I worked at Target Rec for 8 years and I was building computers for customers, I would say 90% of my customers that did SLI were only the high-end users. It was never the mid-range or entry-level gamers. It was never someone would come in and say, hey, I want two GTX 760s to do SLI. No, it was normally, what's the one best card I can get for this amount of money? And I do recommend that anyways over Crossfire or SLI anyway. So even though they don't, I don't think they're going to support SLI in the 1060s, that's fine with me because personally, I don't think anybody's going to be doing SLI with 1060s or RX 480s for that matter. And if you are, I mean, that's fine. That's up to you. But like I said, my recommendation, one card, that's the best thing to do. And hopefully AMD comes out with their big dog later on this year, or at least something more powerful than the 480 to compete more with the 1070 or the 1080. But again, who knows? And sorry that it took me so long to make this video. It took me a long time to make this video. It took me easily 12 hours plus. I had to run through this 3 times on the RX 480s and 3 times on the 1070. And one thing I will let you know too is I've been having a lot of issues with the RX 480 doing these benchmarks. And the reason why I say that is because the capture software for it, like NVIDIA ShadowPlay, is garbage compared to NVIDIA ShadowPlay. They use a thing called Play TV, and the quality is not as good as NVIDIA ShadowPlay. And the other thing too is it's been driving me crazy because some games don't even support their capture software to record. So that's been frustrating. And then the other thing too is anytime I start doing it, every time I start enabling Crossfire, MSI Afterburner goes wacky sometimes and starts flickering like crazy. So I can't even do a video of BF4. Even on my capture, even on my stream box, the capture through the HDMI capture card that I have, I can't do it because everything's flickering like crazy. So that's been driving me up the wall. So it's going to be very hard for me to show you BF4 at least. Just because they did say, I have a friend that does stream, his name, or not really a friend, but I've been watching him quite a bit, and he's been watching my stream too, which is pretty cool, but he's a pretty big streamer, and he's been playing Battlefield 1, and he said pretty much from the performance that he's seeing, if you can run BF4, you can run Battlefield 1 with no problem. So I wanted to benchmark that for you guys, so that way you guys can get a somewhat idea of Battlefield 1 when it comes out. But anyways, guys, I'm going to let you go and enjoy the video. I went ahead and did it in 3 parts, so you'll see the same exact scene for the 1080p, the 1440p, and the 2160p. It is a 30-minute video. I'm going to put the timings at the bottom so you guys can see what timings are for each resolution and so on and so forth. The same setting was ran all the way through all three of them, like I said before, so that way it keeps everything a lot easier to scale. So no anti-aliasing across the board, just to make it easier. And that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you again for being patient, and I almost pulled my hair out today, but it's all good. The video is done. Enjoy it. If you guys enjoyed the video, hit that like button. If you dislike the video and you dislike life, dislike it as well. And if you do dislike it for some reason, again, please let me know feedback-wise. It really does help out. And once again, guys, follow me on Twitch. Follow me on Twitter. I'm posting stuff on there all the time. I'm always streaming at night. And go ahead and spread the love. Spread this video. Post it everywhere. Facebook, Twitch, Twitter. I don't care where you post it, just post it. So that way people see it and they can, when they go purchase these video cards, they know what they're getting without a biased review. You know, I'm very unbiased when it comes to this stuff. You know, I don't care if it's AMD or NVIDIA. I don't have a preference between the two. I just go for what's best at the time. And if you've been following me for a while, I've always had AMD cards. I've always had NVIDIA cards. So once again, that's it, guys. Thank you again, and I'll see you guys in the next one. See ya.
Running their entire global power grid off a single Ceph machine inside this dome.
It can't be that simple.
It really is, mate. You kill the power, you kill Cell. As simple as you like.
No, the Alpha Ceph showed me a vision. We've been through this before. There's got to be a connection somehow.
Prophet, the aliens are gone. You finished them off yourself, just a few waifs and strays left.
No, there's something more. If we can just find a hint, somewhere here, a clue.
Listen, while you were off hunting some super alien that didn't even exist, Cell were busy taking over the world. We need you back in the here and now, boss. We need you to help us stop Cell.
There's more than your revolution going on here. I've seen this. Cell are toying with powers they can't begin to understand. Whatever they're doing, it's going to bring about the end of the world. We have to shut them down.
Fucking right we do. Let's get moving. Give you cover. Let's link up on the far side.
All sector alert. Fugitives are crossing the perimeter. Terminate with extreme prejudice.
Roger!
Guess it was nothing.
Moving up!
He's using a...
Oh, shit. They're here. Call it in. Actual 2-4. HVT is at the bridge area 5. Delta 6. Need backup. Over.
Warning. Fugitives located. Security.
That just made my job a little bit harder. Dive suit. Push forward and we'll link up further down, okay?
Roger that.
Moving out.
Psycho, moving to the next area. Psycho?
Yeah. Copy that.
Psycho, I'm through.
Yeah, I copy. Meet me at the tower elevator.
The turret!
Heads up. Cell setting up turret positions. You can hack them. Wish I could say the same. Once we get inside, we'll RV with my people.
You have people now.
You know me. I've always been a team player.
In anywhere until you give me some answers.
Yeah, I remember.
Most of them are debt slaves. Cell owns our energy, all of it. You can't pay your bills, you have to work it off. Of course you never do, that's the beauty of it. You get stuck in that work-away debt scheme for life. There's no other choice. Well, there is one. You fight. Here, let me show you what Cell have been up to while you've been sleeping. Maybe you'll understand then. Welcome to New York, version 2.0.
What have they done? The city has an energy signature. Why is that?
It's Cell. They're channeling energy from alien technology. Running their entire global power grid off a single Ceph machine inside this dome.
It can't be that simple.
It really is, mate. You kill the power, you kill Cell. As simple as you like.
No, the Alpha Ceph showed me a vision. We've been through this before. There's got to be a connection somehow.
Prophet, the aliens are gone. You finished them off yourself, just a few waifs and strays left.
No, there's something more. If we can just find a hint, somewhere here, a clue.
Listen, while you were off hunting some super alien that didn't even exist, Cell were busy taking over the world. We need you back in the here and now, boss. We need you to help us stop Cell.
There's more than your revolution going on here. I've seen this. Cell are toying with powers they can't begin to understand. Whatever they're doing, it's going to bring about the end of the world. We have to shut them down.
Fucking right we do. Let's get moving.
laser crossing the perimeter. All terminate with extreme prejudice.
Oh shit, shit! They're here! Call it in!
Recon is past
position. Actual 2-4! HPT is at the bridge area 5!
Contact!
Target
cluster!
Over!
It's using arrows!
Warning. Fugitives located. Security.
That just made my job a little bit harder. Need a fucking dive suit.
What's that?
Warning.
watch your back.
You hear that?
Psycho, I'm through.
Yeah, I copy. Meet me in the tower elevator.
Once we get inside, we'll RV with my people.
You have people now.
You know me. I've always been a team player.
I'm not going anywhere until you give me some answers.
Most of them are debt slaves. Cell owns our energy. All of it. You can't pay your bills, you have to work it off. Course you never do, that's the beauty of it. You get stuck in that work-away debt scheme for life. There's no other choice. Well, there is one. You fight. Here, let me show you what Cell have been up to while you've been sleeping. Maybe you'll understand then. Welcome to New York, version 2.0.
What have they done? The city has an energy signature. Why is that?
It's Cell. They're channeling energy from alien technology. Running their entire global power grid off a single Ceph machine inside this dome.
It can't be that simple.
It really is, mate. You kill the power, you kill Cell. As simple as you like.
No, the Alpha Ceph showed me a vision. We've been through this before, there's got to be a connection somehow.
Prophet, the aliens are gone. You finished them off yourself, just a few waifs and strays left.
No, there's something more. If we can just find a hint, somewhere here, a clue.
Listen, while you were off hunting some super alien that didn't even exist, Cell were busy taking over the world. We need you back in the here and now, boss. We need you to help us stop Cell.
There's more than your revolution going on here. I've seen this. Cell are toying with powers they can't begin to understand. Whatever they're doing, it's going to bring about the end of the world. We have to shut them down.
Fucking right we do. Let's get moving.